The dynamic text object displays text located at a string on a PLC, but it only does it when the trigger value is active. For example, this dynamic text object is watching this string tag. Let's put a string in here. And even though we've entered this string, it hasn't appeared yet in the box. That's because it only does it when the trigger tag is active. We specify that this trigger tag is only active when it's a 1. When it becomes a 1, the string appears in the box. Any other number, the string doesn't appear. Let's see how to set this up. Double-click or drag the dynamic text object onto the screen. Or if you see something you like in the parts list, just drag that onto the screen to save yourself the time of setting it up. You have all the formatting features that were covered in the How to Use Common Object Features video, so we're not going to cover those here. You just add a tag for the trigger. We've created one called the trigger tag, and a tag for where the string is located. You can also choose to swap bytes depending on your PLC's format. We don't need that in this example, but we do want to add this scroll text feature. That way, if the text is too long for the box, it'll automatically scroll through the box. This is a big help when you really don't know how long each PLC message will be. Looks like we're all set up here, so let's say OK, simulate, save the project, and up pops our simulator with our new dynamic text object. So let's put some text in here. And again, it does not appear until the trigger meets the conditions that we set. Our trigger was set to be active when it was a 1. And there comes our text. Now, because the text is too long to fit in the window, it automatically scrolls because we checked that option. The great thing about this is this object allows the PLC to change the text to whatever it wants without you having to create the messages ahead of time. Now, the PLC program can add messages later without having to worry about updating the CMore micro code. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.